What is going on? Super exciting. We are headed down to San Antonio today. We have the deal finalized. We are acquiring a company to rebrand for the Austin and San Antonio market, and today is day one. So it's like they say, it can either be day one or one day. And so we're doing it day one today. Let's go.
Obviously, there's been an increase in, you know, pricing from the manufacturer, but insurance has kept up with that.
So yeah.
That's a small component of it. The larger component of it is just what you see as an organization is the longer you're around, the more credibility you have, the more Google reviews you have, the more social media presence. What happens is you're able to get into more affluent neighborhoods, right? It's like for us, like the first time we did a multiple $1 million house, well, guess what? That person referred us to three or four of their friends. So it's just this natural progression as an organization is you just tend to get nicer and nicer homes as long as you're consistently doing really quality work.
Trip.
First thing with results review. So if anybody's like me, I'm a little nervous, so don't worry. We're gonna get through it together, okay? Sound good? In all seriousness, what a super exciting day. Two great teams coming together. And so for a lot of us that have been doing this, actually, you know, going back to Brad and a few others, we started this journey about 8 years ago, right? And our goal was always to become one of the biggest, fastest growing roofing companies, not only throughout the state of Texas, but who knows, right? And so this next phase in our journey is really exciting, and it's going to be very exciting for the rest of us as we continue to hear and see the vision throughout today. So I don't want to steal any thunder. We're going to spend about an hour and a half to 2 hours really telling the story of Results Roofing. So you'll see why we chose them to be our partner, why we said this is the right partner to join forces with to go do the things that we talked about. So we're going to jump in. It's real important that we learn about the history because, again, we want to know what are we joining forces with. So I think you're going to be excited to hear about what Results Roofing's done the last and 4 short years. So I'll turn it over.
So first, I just want to introduce our CEO, my partner in crime, Dustin. I spent, like Jason Pelt, about 27 years in the health club industry. Worked for companies like 24 Hour Fitness and Fitness Connection. I think in my 27 years, I probably worked with about 60,000 employees. And I can honestly say if I were to rack and stack all 60,000 employees and have a number one guy, Dustin was that guy. I was very privileged to meet him 15, 16, 17 years ago as he was coming up through the health club industry. And I was like, wow, man, this guy's an incredible talent, like the best I'd ever seen. And about 5 years ago, we had the opportunity to kind of talk about his vision of the future and Results Roofing. And for me, I was like, man, this is a dream come true to get to partner with him. But what I can tell you is now that I've worked side by side with him the last 5 years, what really makes any great company great is you have to have an incredible leader at the top. So if you look at all the greatest companies in the world, if you look at Apple in their heyday, Steve Jobs, you look at Tesla right now with Elon Musk, you know, all the greatest companies in the world have a common denominator. They have a leader at the top that's a visionary. They can kind of see the future. They can kind of envision of where the company is going to go. You know, I myself, I don't have that skill set. I'm not the type of guy that can come up with the innovative idea. I'm the guy that sits behind someone with those ideas and helps them, you know, get those ideas into place. But Dustin's a visionary. Again, the hardest working guy I've ever seen in my entire life, and he's the engine that makes the whole thing go. So he's gonna start off and give us kind of a rundown of how this whole thing started.
It's all lies. But I think going even further back than this was, I've had a chance to work with Pelt, and I've had a chance to work with Miller for a long time. They were actually both my bosses, and I credit a lot of my success to them, right? Very humbly working with people that set me in position. And so it's funny how everything comes back. I actually worked with Miller and I couldn't stand him. I actually hated him because he always tried to make me better. And I was a top performing sales guy in my companies. And as top performing sales reps, what typically happens is you don't like coaching. You're like, if I'm already number one, how are you gonna coach me to beat people on my team that I'm already beating? Like, I was wearing these people out. Same thing with Jason Pelt. They had a lot of similarities. They'd always push me to be better and I couldn't stand it. I was like, leave me alone. Like, I'm already doing my job. And so Jason, I actually left one time. It was one of the Miller. I guess we're both Jason. Jesus Christ. So when I say Miller and Pelt, so we have an idea, right? And I left Miller, and it was the worst mistake I'd ever made in my life. And I was like, I spent years trying to find that leadership again. And then I found that when I worked with Pelt. And it was great to be able to work with both of them. And so as years went by, I've carried on a relationship with both of them. And I tell you, when all this happened, me and Jason Pelt weren't on the greatest speaking terms, right? We had some falling outs because of ego. It's all it was egos, right? You get two competitors, always laugh, like you lock two people that want to win, you lock them in a room, like they're going to butt heads, right? And it was honestly just stupid and childish. And it was funny, as I was telling my wife one day, I was like, I actually missed the guy and I don't know why. And so when this opportunity came up, we were talking about it and we were like, we want to come to Austin and San Antonio. And our people were like, why don't you look at partnering with a company or merging with a company? And I was like, why don't we do Pelt? And my partners were like, dude, are you serious? I was like, yeah. And I called one person first. Anybody know who that is? I called my wife, right? Wives always know best. And I said, hey, we're thinking about partnering with a company. I'm gonna reach out to them. And I said, Pelt. And she said, fuck you to one brother. And she said, I always love the other brother. I said, really? She goes, I love Jason. She's like, you should. Both of you guys are morons. You both have an ego and you should just talk it out. And I was like, she's absolutely right. So I called him and I go, he's not gonna answer. He answered on the second ring. And that conversation led to, we had a call, it was just him and I, and we started talking. And he goes, hey, I just wanna apologize for what I did. So dude, just stop right there. I said, we both did things. We probably both said things. We probably acted out of emotion. The fact that we're sitting here talking, dude, we don't ever need to bring it up again. Let's go. That's it, let's go. That's how I operate. I don't want to hold grudges. I don't feel like you owe someone a sorry, right? I hate that. Like, you owe me an apology. For what? If we both wronged each other, if we both said things, let's move on. Like, we had a long relationship and we let one thing throw it away. I felt like that was stupid in its own right. So for me, the opportunity to come back and be able to be a part of this with all of you guys and with Jason has been really like life-changing for me. I think it's going to be a life-changing opportunity for all of us. And, you know, I know you guys know, but working with someone like Jason Miller and Jason Pelt, it's a very rare opportunity, right? For somebody that really cares about you, right? Somebody that really will go above and beyond for you. Somebody that, through it all, will coach you to be better. That will do anything in his power to not only make you better professionally, but make you better personally. This guy talked me through a lot of things personally when I was younger. I look at myself when I, man, well, how old was I then? Like 35? I was like 35 then, maybe, when I worked with you, Pelt.
Yeah.
Just had my first child. I was new to the dad world. He even helped me be a better father, right? And those are things that they maybe don't show up in the stat sheet, right? But they show up in the life stat sheet. And so for all of you in this room, I will tell you that I'm privileged and I feel blessed to be able to work with him again. And you have an amazing leader that really cares about you and really cares about the organization. And I can tell you can always tell a lot about someone, and I'll spill the beans. You tell a lot. Every conversation we've had with them has been protecting the team. Like, always asking about the team. Like, this is not gonna change, is it? This is not gonna change. We're like, no. And so for somebody that has so much on the line for his family to care about the team first, it's something super amazing, right? And it's super special.
Hey, one of my guys isn't here.
Hey, dude.
How are you doing?
XL? Any mediums?
Extra.
Oh, yeah, medium.
No.
Any mediums?
One, two. One more. Nice.
Yeah.
There you go.
Marcus, Texas. Huge hailstorm blew through here a few months ago. So we're out here helping our new partners and taking a look at what needs to get done. The previous roofing contractor sold this customer a bag of goods, said they had some commercial metal roofing system. That's not true. So we're helping them get the claim up.
And here's why it's important to have a contractor you can trust. This claim was initially about 90 grand from insurance, and the customer was getting all these estimates, and they're like, wow, I can't get this work done. I'm gonna pay all this additional money out of pocket. Well, we like stepped in and got this to over 150,000. There's still a few things leaving off that we're gonna assist to get the customer right. And so just imagine as a homeowner, you're out there getting these estimates. They were five estimates in, and the cheapest one they had was 135,000, but the insurance was only paying 96. So who was at the fault here? It was really no one. It's just their items that were left off. And so we're going to continue to fight for the homeowner and get this taken care of and just do one last inspection and make sure there's nothing else left off before we get a new metal roof installed. And I brought the Roof Viking. And if you don't know, now you know. This is the king. You heard?
What's up?
This is rated for 300 pounds.
I'm below 300 now.
What were we saying about Evan?
He's got his ladder. He should have a
little, all right.
The nicer one.
No, I'll put it in the valley.
Y'all like one right here?
Yeah, so yeah. You've never done that? So it doesn't slide on this metal?
Yeah, because those like to slide on the aluminum.
You'll notice that my insurance claim includes my workshop.
Okay, yeah, that's right.
But if that's not damaged, I may just not repair the workshop.
Okay.
Probably got a little bit of damage, but may not need repair. So.
Yes, sir.
Hey, what's up? I'm going to get these off for him.
Okay.
Oops. Sir, is there a spot we can put these for you?
Just put that.
Sure. We can move them somewhere. Sorry, sir. We'll throw them out there the road. Yeah, yes, sir.
Thank you.
There you go, Jeff.
That ladder looks so smart.
I thought you were getting up there.
Oh, I'm well.
There we go. He goes well.
Put it a little further back.
Oh, how?
How?
Where were you thinking?
Ooh, that's pretty straight, dude.
Yeah, just hold it, Carl.
I got you. Ain't going nowhere. That ladder, on the other hand, might snap in half.
Well, it won't snap because it's got no bend.
You don't know how the guy is.
Pelt was just being sketch.
And at this moment, he fucked up.
Huh? We signed the papers, right?
I haven't signed anything yet.
Yeah, I'm not going up that one.
Yeah. No, I get up to prove that I can.
It's a no-go, Carm?
I'm not going.
I am.
We can do this.
Weighing 275. That's not new.
You can go.
Johnson, unfortunately, there's the same damage up here.
Yeah. Here. The deal. Taxes went up so much, the insurance went up.
It's not worth it to rent anymore. See, they don't mind taking your premium and raising the insurance, but yeah. They don't want to pay it out.
Let me get the ladder real fast.
That's good, though, but.
Yeah. It's about 95%, but it's included in our cost.
No, I get it.
Yeah. I like company cam, though.
I'd tell you the joke about the ladder, but you probably wouldn't get it. It's over your head. I guess that's the roof joke. Yeah. Either way, sounded good.
I'm tired, motherfucker.
It's hot out here.
Yeah. What do you call when a ladder is replaced with stairs? Climate change. That's a good one.
Ding.
I knew a woman who got a ladder in her tights. She was a great shoplifter. Why should you never trust a ladder? They're always up to something. Let's see what else. Why did the girl bring a ladder to class? She went to high school.
Ha, ha, ha.
Bada boom, bada bing.
No.
Yeah? Yeah, camps.
Wow. Good jump.
Look at this. Is Houston working this month? This is my favorite part. This is like, hey, dude, this fucking, I love, you know what it is? No, it's not even the instigating, it's the competition, dude. Yeah. I fucking love it, dude. Like, I love the competition. I love seeing people because I want to find out what they're made of. Like, because there's two types of people. If I send this to somebody and they're like, oh, I can't believe you sent it to me. And there's other people like, fuck you, dude. I'm going to bury them. That's how I was. And that's how you rise to the top. So it's like, it's pushing that buttons of the competition. Like, let's go, dude. Like, and even if we fall short, okay, but let's fucking go, dude. Like, let's try to win. Let's compete. Let's do everything in our power to do it. That's what I love about it.
With that being said, Carmen, what'd you guys say to camp?
I'm proud of you, camp, for this one little month. Out of the 5 years you've been here.
Oh my goodness.
Bop, 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 bop.